I didn't feel like she was depressed. That's not how I approached it. It felt very, very different to me. And I did this actually a month after doing Fargo. We worked together on this film. But no, I think that, yeah, I
would say, not to speak for you, but it's so interesting because Teresa's kind of, I always think about her as this character that's disoriented. So it's not about a depression. She's suffering grief and she's isolated from people. I don't think she's finding the way to communicate to other people, but she's communicating to the audience, which is really interesting. So, you know, in those moments where, you know, she looks at the glass vase or when she's rubbing her hand on the wall, all those things signify that she wants to stay connected to something, but she's just so unable to. And I guess we always approach it as it wasn't depression, it's this grief you experience at extreme loss. And we've had so many people say, this is exactly like it felt when I suddenly had a new world. Someone was lost in my life, and I could not even understand day to day or time. Like, time's lost. You don't even have the chronological order of living anymore. So it's so interesting that it was more about uncovering this idea of isolation, which leads to her kind of disorientation.